Hi viewers, welcome to the class Chemistry of Electrolysis of Water. This water is a bad conductor or poor conductor, and we are using dilute sulphuric acid to make it conducting without affecting dilute sulphuric acid. So let us see what is the chemistry behind the electrolysis of water. Electrolysis is the process by which electrical energy is used to cause a non-spontaneous or otherwise not happening chemical reaction to occur. Or in other words, we are inducing the reaction to occur by using electricity. Electricity is the strong reducing agent, and electrolysis is the process by which the electrical energy used to cause a non-spontaneous chemical reaction to occur. A electrolytical cell is the apparatus used for carrying out the electrolysis. So essentially, in the electrolytical cell, we'll see two electrodes. Here the electrodes used are platinum electrodes dipped in water, in which some amount, say 0.1 molar sulfuric acid or dilute sulfuric acid, is added in order to facilitate or to have much ions to carry the current or to make the water conducting. As we have seen, water will not spontaneously decompose to become hydrogen and oxygen, because the standard free energy change for the reaction is large and positive, and it is of the order of 474.4 kilojoules per mole. So in that case, it will not be a spontaneous reaction. Delta G, when it is zero or below that or negative, then only spontaneous reaction will occur. Naturally, they will react. Otherwise, we have to use rigorous methods, just like using very high conditions of temperature, pressure, and using powerful techniques like electrolysis. The reaction, you can see water to H2O is decomposed as hydrogen and oxygen. Whenever one molecule of water or two molecules of water is decomposing, we will get two molecules of hydrogen and one molecule of oxygen only. Okay, but this reaction can be induced. It is represented as delta G is positive, and delta G zero is positive, and it is of the order 474.4 kilojoules per mole. But this reaction can be induced in an electrochemical cell. The electrochemical cell consists of platinum electrodes immersed in water, to which 0.1 molar sulfuric acid is added. You can see the experimental setup. You can see the cathode. It's a platinum electrode. Anode also is a platinum electrode, which is dipped in water, which dilute sulfuric acid is added. And at the cathode, you can see hydrogen. And at the anode, oxygen is there. And you can just observe that the volume of at the cathode, that is hydrogen, is just double that of the anode, and that is at the oxygen formed at the anode is only half that of hydrogen at the cathode. Hydrogen at the cathode is twice the volume of oxygen at the anode. When we use pure water only, then almost no reaction will occur. This is because there is not enough ions in pure water to conduct electric current. Pure water at room temperature is having only very small number of ions, of the order of 10 raised to minus 7 H positive ions and 10 raised to minus 7 OH minus ions are present from 1 mole of water. So what happens is, in order to increase the ions of H positive ions, we are adding 0.1 molar sulfuric acid, that's a dilute sulfuric acid, is added, and there will be enough ions to carry out the electric current and the reaction will occur, and we can see bubbles of hydrogen and oxygen appearing at both electrodes. We can see the bubbles coming here. The bubbles are coming from this platinum electrode to release hydrogen, and here at the anode oxygen is coming as bubbles, and you can see the difference in volume also. I have told you twice the volume for hydrogen than oxygen. So appearing at both electrodes you have this hydrogen and oxygen coming. Now what's the chemical reaction involved in this reaction? You can see at the cathode and anode reactions are occurring where water molecule decomposes as hydrogen and oxygen. H2O molecule is decomposed as H positive ions and OH minus ions, and OH minus ions are liberating electrons to give H positive ions, and thereby H positive plus electron giving H one hydrogen atom, and another hydrogen atom uniting to give hydrogen molecule. And OH minus, the 4 OH is there, and that is converted into hydrogen and oxygen once again. Therefore, there will be twice hydrogen and only half that of oxygen. The reaction is, during electrolysis of water, the reaction is 2H2O giving O2 plus 4H positive ions. And the 2H positive ions plus 2 electron give H2 gas. That is, each hydrogen ion will accept one electron to give H atom, H plus H giving H2 gas. And the overall reaction can be written as, on adding it, we will get 2H2O giving O2 plus 4H positive and 2H positive plus 2 electrons giving H positive, will get on adding 2H2O liquid giving 2H2 plus O2. This is the overall reaction. We can see that the added sulfuric acid is not at all interfered here. It only acts as a good conductor of electricity. And H2 plus SO4 is not undergoing decomposition. So that's a simple chemistry behind the electrolysis of water. Electrolysis of water is not a spontaneous, water decomposition is not a spontaneous reaction. And moreover, water is a pure conductor. In order to supplement that, we are adding dilute sulfuric acid, and the reaction occurs to give hydrogen and oxygen. That's all. Thank you for listening. If you find this video useful, please do subscribe.